Hello students, today we will discuss third chapter from Flamingo textbook Deep Water by William Douglas. So in about the author information, William Douglas 1898-1980 was born in Maine, Minnesota after graduating with a Bachelor's of Arts in English and Economics. He spent 2 years teaching high school in Yakima. However, he got tired of this and decided to pursue a legal career. He met Franklin D. Roosevelt at LA and became an advisor and friend to the president. Douglas was a leading advocate of individual rights. He retired in 1975 with a term lasting 36 years and remains the longest serving justice in the history of the court. The following excerpt is taken from Of Men and Mountains by William Douglas. It reveals how as a young boy, William Douglas, neatly drawn in a swimming pool. In this essay, he talks about his fear of water and thereafter how he finally overcome it. Notice how the autobiographical part of the selection is used to support his decision of fear. So here in the beginning, author has introduced some important things in that we can understand that this is the autobiographical element which is discussed in this lesson. And the excerpt is also from here, it is mentioned Of Men and Mountains by William O. Douglas. So we have to think about how the aversion of water, the fear of water, it was finally overcome by the William Douglas, and how it happened, where actually that thing happened, where the fear of the water, it was there in his mind, means that he started fearing about the water, that we can discuss. So here we will start the discussion. It had happened when I was 10 or 11 years old. So here now, this is autobiographical all things. So here the narrator or the author started sharing about the age, and the age is mentioned here 10 or 11 years old. I had decided to learn to swim, and here author is stating that he decided to learn swimming. There was a pool at YMCA in Yakima that offered exactly the opportunity. And here we are also thinking that suppose we will get a nice swimming pool and especially the instructor, then we can go there and swim. Sometime in ocean or river, there are so many problems may be there, and danger may be there. So here also it is same thing, it is reflected. The Yakima River was treacherous and it was dangerous. Suppose you will go there and you will go for the swimming, then sometime so many things, dangerous things may be there in that village. Nearby the village, most of the time, whatever the rivers are or big wells, there usually we are practicing. So here the why the Yakima River was treacherous, there may be problems, means crocodile, so many things, or the area may not be good, understood, inside the rocks, or the condition of that surface may not be good and we may not understand, and suddenly someone may jump and may his head strap to the rocks, or the area may not be good. So here the Yakima River was treacherous. Mother continuously warned against it and kept fresh in my mind the details of each drowning in the river. And here earlier also such type of things happened, that so many newcomers, those who are trying for the swimming, drown in that river. So here it is expressed in this way. And here author is stating that all the mother's words, that remembering that we have taken care, but the YMCA pool was safe. But here the narrator is stating that the YMCA pool was safe. So here narrator decided to learn swimming in that YMCA swimming pool. It was only 2 or 3 feet deep at the swallow end. And here we can observe in the swallow end, most of the time the height of that swimming pool means the water height, especially here it is mentioned at 2 or 3 feet deep. While it was 9 feet deep at the other, to drop was gradual. And here little bit when you will go inside, there 9 feet depth of the water we can experience like that. Here the author is providing the information. I got a pair of water wings and went to the pool. And here author is stating that the instruments which are required for the swimming, especially here a pair of water wings he had taken and went for the swimming. I hated to talk naked into it. Here especially he is mentioning that I hated to walk naked into it and show my skinny legs, but I subdued my pride and did it. And here author is mentioning that we are having also some prejudices sometime, or we may not have that much daring also, sometime awkwardness. So here Douglas is feeling awkward to walk naked into that swimming pool and here show my skinny legs, but I subdued here quiet and rather reflective my pride and I did it. From the beginning, however, I had an aversion to the water. So here aversion is the aversion meaning here we can reflect the aversion means the fear of the water when I was in it. This started when I was 3 or 4 years old and father took me to the beach in California. So here now we can notice, one is YMCA pool, then second is Yakima River, and third is beach in California. So three different places here it is mentioned, and in that this YMCA pool it is safe, Yakima River it was not safe for the swimming as per the mother's info, then beach in California. So this new reference here we are getting, and what happened there we can add, he and I stood together in the surf. I hung on him, at the wave knocked me down and swept over me. And we can observe a very important thing in that, when in especially in the ocean that thing happened, here the wave, and we can observe the waves, how fast that waves are coming, and very means when you are at the earliest stage when you will go, that wave power may create problem to you. And the same thing here, I was buried in water, my breath was gone, I was frightened. Father laughed, But there was terror in my heart at the overpowering force of the waves. So here it is clearly mentioned that the fear of the water, fear of the water started. And here in the earlier it is mentioned that 3 or 4 years old. Hence here we can observe that he was with a father at the time of surfing. Here we can understand the father was there, but still he observed the laugh and laugh of the father. Father laughed because father might have knowledge that nothing will happen, but the small boy, he was totally frightened. And why the condition happened like this? Because I was buried in water, my breath was gone. And when you will suddenly go in the water, then you may not breathe properly, and suddenly the fear of the water may arose in your mind. I was frightened, father laughed, but there was terror in my heart at the overpowering force of the waves. And it was not only the fear, now it becomes like a terror. It was now the terror thing, horrific thing, and it was stuck in the mind of William Douglas. So this is the very important key event. So the question might be asked concerned with this, the first event, when actually the aversion of water, it was there in his mind, and that aversion of water afterwards also, when he decided to take actual swimming with the help of instructor. That time also, now the same kind of fear, the experience, the better experience when he was there in the beach of California. Then next, my introduction to the YMCA swimming pool revived unpleasant memories. And that unpleasant memories here, author is talking about the beach in California. And here, steed, childish fear. Steed means arose strong feelings of that child. Here, author is mentioning the childish. But why it was the childish? Because he don't know more about the waves and the surface. It was the surface level, means it was not deep water. But then also there was a childish fear, and it was there in his mind. And here how steed childish fear. Steed means arouse strong feelings of the same sensation or the aversion or the fear of the water. But in a little while I gathered confidence, and again I have taken decision that I know I am confident. I gathered some kind of confidence. I paddled with my new water wings, watching the other boys and trying to learn by apping them. Means by apping them means just imitating them, not technically. Here instructor is required. He was just imitating that how others are swimming, and he was also imitating the same, apping them. I did this 2 or 3 times on different days and was just becoming to feel at ease in the water when the misadventure happened. And now author is talking about the misadventure. And what is that misadventure? Here in the next passage, here it is mentioned. I went to the pool when no one else was there. The condition is here. He went to the YMCA pool, and the condition is no one was there. The place was quiet, and the place was very quiet. The water was still because no one was there, so water was still. The tile bottom was as white and clean as bathtub, and the tile water means he was able to see the bottom of the YMCA pool. Then the next thing we can here observe, and what is that next thing? I was timid about going in alone and so sat on the side of the pool to wait for others. And he was not that much confident. He was timid here, it is mentioned. So he was waiting for the others. When others will come, then only he will enter. He will go into the water. I had not been there long when in came a big brosher boy, means very aggressive, tough, such kind of boy. He was there, of a boy, probably 18 years old. So here, William Douglas character is there, and this one more character here it is introduced, and that is a big brosher of a boy, probably 18 years old. He had thick hair on his chest. So here, suppose the question will be asked for 2 marks. Describe the big brochure boy, and then you can describe using this explanation. So here, how the physical description of the boy, it is given, probably 18 years old. He had thick hair on his chest. He was a beautiful physical specimen. Maybe because of the his physical fitness, all here it is mentioned. So beautiful physical specimen with legs and arms that showed rippling muscles, and he might be practicing gymnasium all. So here we can observe that if somebody is doing the exercise, proper exercise with instructor in gym, then all that rippling muscles, all arms, all things we can observe. He yelled, and that the big brochure boy yelled, "Hi, skinny. How would you like to be ducked? How would you like to be ducked?" Means ducked here means to push under water. And how you would like to be? You are alone. So this type of expression here it is given. With that, he picked me up and tossed me into the deep end. I landed in a sitting position, means he was sitting there, and as like that boy might be lift him and thrown him in the water. So here, picked me up and tossed me into the end, and I landed in a sitting position. As I was as like that, the sitting position, now he tossed me in that same position and swallowed water and went at once to the bottom. I was frightened, but not yet frightened out of my wits. And still he was thinking that I will plant something. And here on the way down, I planned when my feet hit the bottom, I would make a big jump, came to the surface, lie flat on it, paddle to the edge of the pool. When he was going down, he planned something that I can survive, I can do certain things. Means when he was observing others, how they are swimming. So like that here, thinking process, it was good, and he started thinking positively. Here, on the way down, I planned when my feet hit the bottom, and it was only the 9 feet. So his feet here hits the bottom, I would make a big jump, came to the surface, lie flat on it, and paddle to the edge of the pool. I seemed a long way down. Those 9 feet were more than 90. And now he started thinking that it was only the 9 feet, but now for him it was like a 90 feet. And before I touched bottom, my lungs were ready to burst. And now here we can observe that the William Douglas, he was totally frightened. But when my feet hit bottom, I summoned all my strength. And again, he was taken decision, means thinking, he was thinking positively, and he summoned all his strength. He had taken, get together all the things and confidence here, my strength, and made what I thought was great spring upwards. I imagine I would bob to the surface like cork. So here make short movement up and down like a cork, and I can come out and I can float properly, I can swim properly. So like that, I came up, instead I came up slowly, opened my eyes and saw nothing. And when he came up, what means here the expression it is like, the I opened my eyes and saw nothing but water. Means now water was everywhere, like that here. No one was there, he was alone. Others were not there in that swimming pool. The big brochure boy came and he tossed him into the water, and he was he landed himself in the sitting position, and now only he was observing the water. Water that had a dirty yellow tint to it. I grew panically. I reached up as if to grab a rope, and my hands clutched only at water. I was suffocating. I tried to yell, but no sound came out. Then my eyes and nose came out of water, but not my mouth. So here the condition of the drowning condition, how is the condition and how we struggle. So here he is mentioning that he was suffocating, and sometime here it is mentioned, then my eyes and nose came out, but my mouth was not coming out. And here he was just here one more. I reached up as if to grab the rope, and my hands clutched only at water. And it was the thing happened that his hands also. Now when suppose you are the good swimmer, you can understand the condition. That suppose anyone who is not properly doing the exercise, then he may not be able to swim. So here are some steps we have to follow. Using that some steps, we can easily swim. But he was very new to that all environments, and suddenly he was there in the 9 feet deep water. And earlier also the event happened about him, and that aversion of water was still there in his mind. So here I fled. So here thrash or strike at surface of the water, and swallowed and choked, and that water he was engulfed the water also, and here is everything now choked. I tried to bring my legs up, but they hung as a dead weights, paralyzed and rigid. And now my legs also, it was like a paralyzed. No, I cannot move from that place. So like that condition now here it has happened, because he was trying. First at the beginning he tried to come out, then he summoned his strength, confidence also, but he was not able to do, because he had not taken proper training, and practice is required. So here swimming is a skill, and for any skill oriented things, practice is required. So here there was no practice, so he was getting the bitter experience through this. The great force was pulling me under, and here the great force was pulling me under. Whenever I am coming out again, the great force, it is pulling me down. So like that here experience we can understand. So here I scream means give a loud piercing sound or cries. But then also here what happened, I screamed, but only the water heard me. Here no one was there. So here author is mentioning the only the water heard me. I had started on the long journey back to the bottom of the pool, and again I have started journey the bottom of the pool. Means here he was coming up, again he was going down, and like that here condition. Now I struck at the water as I went down, expending my strength as one in the nightmare fight. An irresistible force. I had lost my breath, and now this is the very critical condition. And here author is mentioning that I have lost my breath also. My lungs ached, my head throbbed. So here, all the condition here he is mentioning is that all conditions are totally critical conditions. He is mentioning that I struck at the water and water as I went down, expending my strength as one in the nightmare fights and irresistible force. I had lost my breath, my lungs ached, my head throbbed, I was getting dizzy. So here the meaning of the word dizziness means you are losing the balance, the unconscious state of like that. Here he is mentioning, but I remember the strategy. I would spring from the bottom of the pool and came like a cork to the surface. And he was still positive that he can come out like a cork. I would lie flat on the water, strike out with my arms and thrash with my legs. Then I would get to the edge of the pool and be safe. So here he was trying his best level, but he was not able to get the proper things, and he was not successful in his all attempts. Then here I went down, down endlessly. I opened my eyes, nothing but water with yellow glow. So here slightly shine that yellow water at the bottom he was observing, dark water that one could not see through. And he was mentioning that I was observing such type of dark water that I cannot see properly, like that here yellowish water, the pale here thing here. It, he is mentioning the glow, yellow glow means slightly shine. And then sheer stark terror seized me. And then the severe, the terror, again the aversion, the fear of the water, and it was like a terror seized me, terror that knows no understanding, terror that knows no control, terror that no one can understand who has not experienced it. And such type of terror no one can understand. Suppose you have experienced such type of drowning condition, then only you can understand. So here he is mentioning that no one others can understand. Just by explanation you may not get that feel. When you have experienced, then only you can understand me. So like that here he is mentioning. I was striking under the water, I was paralyzed under the water. And his condition was like he was paralyzed, his legs means hands, nothing it was moving, like that condition he is mentioning. And then here stiff, rigid with fear. And it was stiff, it was rigidness of the arms or the body parts he was experiencing. Even the screams in my throat were frozen. And here he was mentioning that the condition of the throat, because of means his throat, everything, it was already choked because of the he was facing the problem of breathing, the water might be in. So condition it was like that. Only my heart and the pondering in my head, means the thinking, said that I was still alive. And only the heart was still okay, it was functioning, and the thinking it was still there. So he was thinking that I am still alive. And then in the midst of the terror came a touch of reason. I must remember to jump when I hit the bottom. And he was thinking that whenever I will go to the bottom, I must hit, and then only I can come out. At last I felt the tiles under me, my toes reached out as if to grab them. I jumped with everything I had. So he was jumping everything he had, the all he used to gather his all things he used to summon. But the jump made no difference. But the jump also made no difference. I was not able to come out from that deep water. The water was still around me. I looked for ropes, ladders, water wings, nothing but water. a mass of yellow water held me. Stark terror took an even deeper hold on me, like a great charge of electricity. So here he was mentioning it was like a shocking, like electricity. I was not able to control all that things. So here, stark terror, and it was the stark terror now. It was engulfed me, and I was not able to come out from that. I shook and trembled with fright. My arms wouldn't move. My legs wouldn't move. So arms means the hands wouldn't move. The legs also wouldn't move. It was like a paralyzed things. I tried to call for help, to call for mother. Nothing happened. So here, nothing happened now. Everything, it was totally disturbed. So now here, author is mentioning that what will happen next. And then, strangely, there was a light. I was coming out of the awful yellow water. And then something strange thing happened. And I came out from that awful water. So awful means very bad, unpleasant water. At least my eyes were, my nose was almost out too. And here my nose was a little bit up, but still the other body parts maybe. Then I started down a third time. Means I started down the third time. I sucked for air and got water, and he was sucking for the means breathe, but what would happen, he was going down, so water may come in the nostrils. The yellowish light was going out. Then all efforts ceased, and now after third time here, he is mentioning that then all efforts ceased means stop. I relaxed, and now he is mentioning in negative way that now I relaxed, because nothing was working. My hands also, it was like paralyzed. My legs also, it was because of the breathing and the dizziness. I was not able to think. Means it was a unconscious state of mind here. It was off. Even my legs felt limp. Means it was walk with difficulty. I was not able to do anything. And a blackness swept over my brain. I whiffed out fear, it whipped out terror. There was no more panic. So here he is mentioning that the more than this, nothing would be panic to me. It was quiet and peaceful, and now he was thinking about the death, the condition, and so he was thinking that it was now very quiet and peaceful, nothing to be afraid of. And now why to afraid? What is going to happen, I can understand. So nothing to afraid. This is nice to be drowsy. This is nice to be drowsy, to go to sleep. No need to jump. Now it is better to go to sleep, means now he was thinking about the death. No need to jump, and he was now thinking, now no need to jump also, nothing is going to happen. So no, he ceased all his efforts to try to jump. It is nice to be carried gently. And now when I will stop everything, then water will itself carry me. I may come out, and then everything will be finished. A float along in space, the tender arms around me, and the tender arms here reflected as a water. Tender arms like mothers, and like mothers, that tender arms, it will not harm me anything. I will come out with gentle way. So here, tender arms like, but all that things he is mentioning negatively. Now I must go to sleep. And he was thinking that now nothing is going to happen. I will surely die. So here, I crossed to oblivion, state of being unaware or unconscious. And then he was in an unconscious state of mind, and the curtain of life fell. And the curtain of life means the my survival conditions. Now, no chance to any survivals. So here he was approaching to the death. So like that here, up till this, author had given very horrific experience of drowning the water and how he experienced everything. And then in the next course of the story, plot development of the story, then he means the author described how he overcome that fear of the water and finally he conquered. So up till this, now we will today discuss in next video, we will discuss the next part of the story. Thank you.